Well, I guess if there's a time to leave for Florida, it's right now. Because it's snowing. What a way to start off the trip, huh?
I'm Sleeve1080, and this is my son, Shortsleeve. And usually we are streaming video games live on Twitch, making YouTube videos, or posting short stories from Facebook. But when one of the most powerful hurricanes to hit the United States slams into your hometown, and this is what your mother's house looks like, you pack your bags, board a plane, and head to Florida to help. But not before you call this guy, John Mahoney of the Morgan Law Group, serving all your hurricane litigation needs. John Mahoney and the Morgan Law Group are not associated with Sleeve1080 and did not sponsor this video, but I trust him enough to take care of my mother, and I think that says a lot, and I'd like to give him a shout out. So call John Mahoney and the Morgan Law Group today.
Is there water up there for people to take?
Oh, that's like supplies or whatever?
I don't know.
Like
I'm just
apples and onions.
Like oh, apples. Does it look like there's water and supplies? I don't know. That would have been a good thing for us to do. Everybody put water there.
Well, I know the park. What's that? Basketball. Oh, basketball court got wrecked.
I can't. I gotta record under the crack.
Yeah.
Trying to get.
That's a garage door, wow. Mine's all fitted up. Look, there's where a boat ended up. They had a boat in their front yard.
That's where a boat ended up?
Uh-huh.
What, it just came out, it was right there?
It just swimmed over here.
Yeah, a couple people had boats in their front yards over there.
I wonder what happened to Danny's boat.
Maybe somebody moved that one there. But people had boats in their front yard.
For like evacuation or something?
No, from the flood.
Yeah.
They've been coming around every day getting the junk. I mean,
that's incredible. Well, I guess it's been 2-3 weeks. So.
Yeah, oh yeah. I mean, it was getting so bad you couldn't quite get through the couldn't get through the road. It was getting so narrow.
Really? So it's gotten cleaned out more than half?
Oh, yeah. This is the guy that wanted $10,000 to do my house.
What do you mean?
To come in and do what we're doing right now.
Oh, what, just to clean it up?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
They've been working over here. This guy must have just left his stuff sit.
Oh, is this all your stuff?
There he is.
There he is.
What's he doing now? What's he tying up? He hasn't had a bath since the hurricane.
Well, here we are in the danger zone. The aftermath of Hurricane Ian. So let's walk around and see what's up.
As I walked around the property and assessed the damage that was left in the wake of the devastation brought on by Hurricane Ian, I couldn't help but be flooded by the memories of life that was spent here over the last 10 years.
All right, a little better. Are you ready? Okay. Boom!
I found it fitting to start in the garage, not because it's one of my favorite Weezer songs, but because Shortsleeve and I called it our home when we moved back in with my parents for a few years. It was honestly my favorite room I ever had, because we made it our own, and I love vaulted ceilings. My brother Vince built that gate in his lucky horseshoes on the right-hand side. Yeah, it's still standing. Shortsleeve and I laid those stepping stones in pea gravel. I designed it after the Sanibel Moraine's walkways. Though I couldn't place it at first, it was the sound that was making this experience feel so down and dreary. No one was splashing in their pools, talking and laughing by their grills while having a cocktail party. No one fishing or launching their boats in the river. No one walking their dogs or riding their bikes. Yes, all the joyous sounds of this wonderful Florida community had been replaced. Replaced by the distant beep of a backhoe clearing debris, the soft thud of a hammer fixing a roof, the grind of a chuck on a screw gun hanging new drywall, and the occasional thud of someone tossing their belongings into a ditch at the end of the road, only for a crane to come and take and haul it all away. Yes, it was the sound that made this all so real. This fire pit patio that Short Sleeve and I built now had a boat dock in it that came from, well, who knows where. We had many great memories of nights with a cookout like this one, with Uncle Vince. That's the pool and patio where I started my YouTube career, with Bat Vape, with Danny and Vince. My brother Vince planted those banana trees from saplings, and my brother Colton planted those pines from a tree he got at Publix. One summer, Short Sleeve and I grew watermelons out by the pool.
Show me some splashes. Yeah, all right.
Short Sleeve learned to swim in that pool, and then a few years later, he learned to swim to the bottom on Easter to pick up the Easter golf balls that I left for him. We did that instead of eggs. This is the master bed and bath. My buddy Danny also tiled this shower for my parents. This was my mom's walk-in closet. And this side was my dad's. My buddy Mike and I removed all the tile in this bathroom and in the rest of the house after Hurricane Irma. That's right, this house has survived 2 hurricanes. And Short Sleeve has helped during both. This is my mom back in March showing off her newly renovated kitchen. But just like my dad always used to say, he never saw a second putt he didn't like. Well, you're gonna get a mulligan, Mom, so make it perfect this time. Hey, that's where I shot the Destiny desk. There's Vinny catching some Z's. He rode it out the house during the hurricane.
There he goes.
We had a lot of great times in this house. And there's Short Sleeve in his old room with his drums when we rented the house for my parents when they lived in Tennessee. I tried out a lot of hairstyles and practiced a lot of characters in this bathroom mirror. This is me doing my best Bret the Hitman Hart. In my room, where I shot my voiceovers and recorded songs, it's a creator's closet, okay? The necessities. I made a lot of great meals in this kitchen. Here's one. And here's a Short Sleeve birthday memory with our neighbor Eva. My sister took her senior prom pictures by those palm trees. And I grew those Indian hawthorns for our landscaping with our neighbor Ryan out on his farm. And Short Sleeve and my dad planted them. And my brother Colton took his senior prom pictures on these steps. And even though the contents of this home is laying out in the middle of the ditch, You'll never take the memories away. So we started in the garage and we ended in the garage, and I can't say that I was overjoyed, but I knew that there was work to be done. And whenever I'm feeling down or a little low, I think back to one of my first memories and one of my favorite movies, The Ghostbusters.
There's office space, sleeping quarters, and showers on the next floor, and there's a full kitchen on the top level.
It just seems a little pricey for a unique fixer-upper opportunity, that's all. What do you think, Egon?
I think this building should be condemned. There's serious metal fatigue in all the load-bearing members. The wiring is substandard. It's completely inadequate for our power needs. And the neighborhood is like a demilitarized zone.
Hey, does this TV still work? Wow, this place is great. When can we move in? You gotta try this TV. I'm gonna get my stuff.
Hey, we should stay here tonight. Sleep here, you know, to try it out.
Because Ghostbusters is about the everyman and how to prevail in the face of adversity when the cards are stacked against you and everyone's going to need your help, even though they don't know it yet.
I think we'll take it.
Good.
Give you guys a little tour of the accommodations.
All right, back in, a little air mattress action, a little end table. Got the AC hooked up and going, baby. Yeah. Got a little closet action. We're doing good.
Hurricane renovation day number two. We're gonna clean these floors. Benny's on the shop back. I got the mop. We're gonna hit it with the boolie, then go back over here with the bleach. Let's go.
And if you had any question if you think I was really a Ghostbusters fan or not, you can see I'm rocking the shirt right now. So I'm gonna let some of this footage play out as we do our work. And I'll fill in with commentary from time to time during the stills. And I didn't have time to film all the projects that we did, but what I could, I'm going to show you now. So sit back, relax, and enjoy, and this is probably going to be a multi-part video series, so here we go.
Alright, I'm going to show you guys the before and after of a spot that we already did. I'm going to track a little dirt over here, we'll check it out. Alright, we moved on from mopping the floors. We're going to put in a temporary new kitchen sink with the old faucet in it. So, check this out. Just doing a little plumbing.
You can't play Call of Duty. You gotta come down here and work on the hurricane shit. You know what I mean?
Not going to finish the battle pass this year, this season.
So after we got clean, we got organized, and Short Sleeve and my mom set up a makeshift living area in the lanai, and I set up a workshop in the living room. Makeshift slop sink worked out great, and we also set up a makeshift kitchen out on the lanai, which served us well with many meals as we ate after a long, hard day's worth of work. Even though one day we were too tired to cook, we just went ahead and got pizza from Rosati's. Do the one in the stereo, it's way better. Every evening I was graced by some of the most beautiful sunsets I've ever seen in my life. It was truly amazing, the calm after the storm. Everything was going beautifully until one evening I fell out the makeshift steps that I made in the back of the lanai with a dirty bucket of mop water that spilled on my head, and I got a nice contusion and rip and tear on my knee and leg. But the mornings were bright and we carried on, so I've got to fix that steps, and here was the next day.
Well, here we are, another day, hurricane zone.
Today we're going to cut this boat dock up that landed in our backyard, and I kind of already got started. We're using this little electric chainsaw, working real good right now, but we're going to fix the step where I took a big tumble. So we're going to chop this up and see if we can't repurpose it. Let's do it. We're gonna fit that in there, secure it down. I think that's gonna work out good. All right, welcome to Ground Zero. Operation today, power wash this garage floor. Let's do it! Boom! There we go. Got it all done. Looks good. Way better in here. Don't even know what day this is anymore, but we've installed a master sink as well. We'll get that one running. Little makeshift. We got the shark bites down there. Plugged in. Temporary fix for now, so keep plugging away at her. All right, gang, we're still plugging away here. It's been a long time. Anyway, we're gonna put some plywood up on the drywall here in the master so we can have some air conditioning. So we're gonna do that today. That's what we're gonna work on next. Take you back here. So at least we can have air in one room. So we're gonna block that off. We'll have a little air conditioner and keep it cool. Let's get started. We got her all boarded up. We'll just add a little bit of plastic and tape it off, and should hold the air in real good. Oh, except there's no door. Wait a minute. Found one. Now people have been saying to me, "Miss Sleeve, are you sure you want to take the bathroom door off?" And I said, "Well, here's why that's not a problem. Because when you're in there taking poop, you can look right in through the front door. Right there, right into the bathroom. So it really doesn't matter if there's a door over here, right? I don't know, hang some curtains or something, and sheet of plastic, trash bag, tape it on there, whatever, but we gotta have that AC. All right, let's take off this door. All right, the door is on. It does shut. I just didn't throw it hard enough. Here we go. Boom. Got the mattress blowed up. Got the wall in. We can hook some AC up in here. Getting things done. Hurricane Ian 2022.
I couldn't end this video without mentioning the Minutemen, who came and volunteered their time for 2 days and helped us with the rest of the drywall removal and moving the broken countertops outside the house and much, much more I couldn't have done on my own. You guys are truly doing the Lord's work. And after these 2 weeks, Shortsleeve and I were originally scheduled to return on the verge of a Modern Warfare 2 and Warzone 2 release, but my mom convinced me that there was more work to be done, more people to help, and more money to be made. So we rescheduled our flights. But those stories are for another video, and I hope you have enjoyed what you've seen so far. But stay tuned for the next part of our hurricane adventure. And until next time, I'm Sleeve 1080, and we'll see you in the next one.
We got ourselves some new ridgeless brushes combo pack here. We're ready to do some work. Let's check it out. Boom. Smells like hard work. Let's open this puppy up. We got to register these things for their lifetime warranty and put them in our digital toolbox. We have got... Look at that. It's beautiful. All right, I got to punch in some serial numbers and get these things ready to go. And we also got the 18-inch brushless circular saw. I'm going to register that one now, too.